Good evening, I'm Ricky Carandang.
I'm Linda Humilia.
Tonight, in cooperation with the Management Association of the Philippines, Kilos Bayan, and the Movement for Good Governance, we begin E-Leksyon, the 2010 Voter Education Series.
The series aims to raise awareness among the voting population and possibly find solutions to the various problems and issues confronting the nation as we hold in May the country's first ever automated national polls.
We start off the series by bringing together here in the Dolphy Theater different stakeholders who will discuss the issues as members of the panel and of our audience.
At ang series na ito po ay mapapanood ninyo sa ANC at sa DZMM Teleradio at mapapakinggan sa Radio Patrol sa East 30. At dahil ito ang unang pagtutulungan ng ABS-CBN News Channel at ng DZMM Teleradio sa isang forum, kasama po natin ngayong gabi ang pinakapamilyar o isa sa mga pinakapamilyar na mga boses sa DZMM, ang kinagigiliwan na dos por dos, sina Anthony Taberna at Jerry Baha.
Thank you, Ricky and Linda. Magandang gabi po mga kapamilya, ito po si Jerry Baha.
Ito po naman si Anthony Taberna, muli pong sumasa inyo ang dos por dos, kaya lang eh hindi na po namin oras to. Nakikisalo lang po kami sa oras ng palatuntunang ito. Nandito po kami ni Kumbachero para po tulad ninyo ay makinig
at magtanong.
Kasama po kami ng mga kapamilya nating nandito sa studio audience ng Dolphy Theater at alam po namin ng mga nakikinig po sa radyo, nanonood sa telebisyon, lalo na po sa teleradyo at ang mga nasa iba't ibang panig ng buong daigdig ay marami ding katanungan kaugnay po ng nalalapit na halalan.
At mga kapamilya, simulan na natin ang eleksyon.
Ang 2010 Voter Empowerment Series.
The Commission on Elections has encountered a number of delays in preparation for the country's fully automated polls in May. The COMELEC was supposed to print ballots last Monday, January 25th, but the poll body announced that it would instead begin printing on Sunday, January 31st, to accommodate any changes in the list of qualified candidates.
We have to be very honest na until now may mga cases for disqualification. Baka magkaroon ng kunting adjustment kami sa data.
This is the second delay in the printing of ballots. If it followed the original timeline, the COMELEC would have started printing ballots more than 2 weeks ago on January 7th. By now, the poll body should also have set up the machines and begun testing them with the printed ballots. But as it is, the COMELEC has postponed its testing via mock elections twice. The December 17th mock polls, which was moved to January 30th, is now set for February 6th. The delays have prompted Watchdog Group Automated Election System, or AES, to give the COMELEC a failing grade in its poll preparations. They point out COMELEC has yet to train teachers and educate voters about the new voting process ahead of the election.
COMELEC and its consortium partners Smartmatic TIM are not prepared to fully automate the May 2010 elections, putting the coming elections at great risk.
Church leaders have also expressed doubts about the reliability and integrity of the counting machines. Catholic Bishops Conference of the Philippines says COMELEC must have a backup plan to ensure that there won't be a failure of elections. In the next several days, the COMELEC is expected to determine whether or not the landmark automated elections can proceed. But despite the delays and other issues being raised about the polls, including security and systems, the poll body says so far, so good.
So far, all indicators are that end-to-end system works. We need to say the votes, the ballots were read, the votes were counted, the data transmitted by the PCOS machine were transmitted to the canvassing server.
No way shall we be waylaid or distracted by the critics. The agencies we depend on, they'll be the ones to tell us it's go or no go.
If the system fails, the country has no choice but to go back to manual balloting. If it comes to that, the COMELEC says it still has plenty of time to prepare for a manual vote. So many questions, so many concerns, and tonight we hope we can address all of these. You can join our discussion online by logging on to www.abs-cbnnews.com/ANC live events for our live chat. You can also post your comments and questions on Twitter using the hashtag ANC Forum. For our first segment, joining us now in the panel is COMELEC Commissioner Gregorio Larrazabal and from Smartmatic, Cesar Flores.
At kasama naman po sa ating audience ang ilan sa ating mga tumatakbong kandidato ngayong halalan. Isa rin sa kanila si Brother Eddie Villanueva at ilan pang mga senatorial hopefuls. Also here are representatives from various civil society groups and other stakeholders in the elections, including the Movement for Good Governance, the Management Association of the Philippines, Kilos Bayan, the Alliance of Concerned Teachers, Automated Election Systems, Watch, SENPEG, the labor sector, the academe, our fellow journalists and bloggers. So let's get the ball rolling. Simulan na natin, Ricky.
Thank you, Linda. Commissioner Larrazabal and Mr. Flores, thank you again for coming tonight. Umpisahan po natin yung usapan natin with an update. Where are we in the process right now? I know we've just done some field tests, so maybe you can tell, you can walk us through where we are exactly.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for the invitation. Well, as you have been following in the last weeks, we are in the final stages of the systems test. It's a standard procedure after all the customization is done, and you have a final platform that you go out in the field and start testing the final configurations of the platform, precisely to see what type of issues you encounter, in order to correct them before you have the final version. So basically, we conducted the lab test, which case we do an end-to-end testing of the system, and then we take that checked system in the field, in the form of a field test that we conducted on Wednesday and also today. And basically, that allows us to see the behavior of the whole end-to-end system out there, from the moment the votes are cast, passing through the transmission and the canvassing. And we can say that the system is working as expected, and also it gives us a better insight at the type of issues that we will encounter in real life on the day of elections.
What were some of those issues? Because we were watching, as you know, you've invited the media to watch the field tests. What we saw in our news reports was there seemed to be some problems with transmission. Most of the time, the machines apparently went through, except for a few times. But there were some times, like in Taguig, for example, hindi might transmit yung resulta. There was no signal or something like that. What percentage of the tests were smooth and what percentage had some problems?
Well, it's very important that you ask that. And it's important that the people know that there will be issues. I mean, it will be naive to think that nothing will happen. The important thing is that we know what to do when something comes up. And out of the site survey, we already know that about only 65% of the precincts will have a steady telecommunications capacity. So the question is what to do about it. And what happened in Taguig is exactly that. There will be precincts where the transmission using the GPRS or the regular cell phone networks won't be available, and that's where you resort to, for instance, in this case, the satellite transmission. And this is exactly what we expect in this kind of test. What to do when all of a sudden you cannot transmit using the cell phone networks, and you have to resort to the